Tyson around it. You know, you can't train a Mike Tyson like for instance. Mike Tyson, his style is unique. It works for him. But you can't get like a James Toney and try to get him to fight like Tyson.
That's true.
Or vice versa. That's what made James Toney so good was his style, his ability to fight.
Fighting like that. On the ropes, the shoulder roll, nobody really did it like him, except you know, Floyd does
so
it. But
I think that's what Billy understands with me, is he understands my style and we work around it. You know what I'm saying?
So if a young fighter's watching this, given all your experiences in boxing, the ups, the downs, the highs, the lows, what advice would you tell a young fighter?
I mean, I think like you gotta be obsessed with this, man. You gotta believe in yourself 100%. Honestly, you can't go by what other people say, or you can't go by somebody else's approval. Like, you just can't.
You gotta believe in yourself.
Because a lot of people are scared to do what they wanna do.
Yeah.
And they project their fears on you. So they're scared of what they can't do. So they tell you can't do it. But, I mean, you just can't go by that. So you just gotta believe in yourself, you gotta work on your craft, you gotta do your homework, you gotta study films. Like, man, when I first started doing this, I watched film all day.
What did you watch, like trainers?
I watched James Toney. I listened to trainers, like Customato. I mean, if I saw Muhammad Ali running in boots, I'll put my terminus on and I'll go run in boots.
No.
It's probably not good for you. And I highly doubt that it is good for you.
No.
But I would do.
He probably didn't have a choice.
Like, let me tell you something. Old school trainers wouldn't let you drink water.
Yes.
Is that good for you?
No.
No, it's not good for you. But guess what? I would do it when I was coming up. I would listen to them. If I was in a lot, if they told me don't drink water, I didn't drink water.
Yeah.
Because it's built in character. It's not because, you know what I mean, like, of course you need to drink water.
Hey, I was in the army.
But it was built.
And they didn't let us drink water.
It was built in character.
Yes.
And my trainer said, you're going to spar 5 minute rounds a day.
Yeah.
You don't question them, you do it. You feel like you're about to die in the ring, but you just do it. And that builds character. So these up and coming fighters, I see a lot of them are spoiled and
entitled,
entitled, and it's like, you know.
Listen, amateurs is nice, but it doesn't mean anything in the pros.
You just gotta pay your dues, man.
Well, there's a problem too, Gab. Look, today, if you're popular, let's say social media, you have tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of followers, you think you made it, but it doesn't mean anything.
Yeah, you know, social media got a lot of these young fighters messed up, you know, and you know, it was crazy, like coming up. Whenever they had me fight for titles,
yeah.
If the title did not get me ranked, I had no interest in it. If you was gonna put me to fight for a title, it absolutely meant nothing. I didn't want it. My mentality was like, I'm not fighting for this. My mentality is, I want to fight for titles that mean something. You know, so I fought for the WBO interim, I won that. The NABF, NABO, WBA, I fought for two world titles. You know what I'm saying? Like, if ever they try to make a fight for a title that was meaningless, I want no parts of it.
I'm going to tell people two things. Maybe probably most people don't know this about you. You had two fights that you could have taken the easiest opponents, got paid more, even easy wins.
Yeah.
But you chose to fight the toughest opponent you can, which not a lot of people do that.
Yeah.
Like you fought Triple G, they offered you to fight at 58. And what did you say?
Yeah.
You said, no, I want him at 60. That's the weight.
But that's why I'm still here, 13 years later. You're lucky to have a 10-year career.
You're right.
This is my 13th year as a pro. And every people wonder, damn, Gabe's still around.
Yeah.
And Gabe is even looking better now. But why?
Are you more popular now than ever, do you feel like? Do you get recognized more?
Well, I guess, but, you know, I think I'm still here standing because it's character.
The war, yeah. Never backing down from any challenge.
At the end of the day, I don't care how clean you eat. I don't care how many miles you run. I don't care about none of that. This is about character. The ring, when it comes down to you feeling like you about to die in that ring, it don't come down to if you ate your veggies. It don't come down to that shit. You know what I'm saying? It come down to you got this.
You're right.
Not if you ate your veggies, not if you ran a cook. No, it come down to character.
Yep.
And you either got that or you don't. That's 100. You got Chico Corrales, when he got rocked by Castillo and he went down.
Yep.
He's about to be out. And man got right back up and knocked out Castillo.
Fight
you think
century.
He did that because he was eating his veggies?
No.
Or you did that because that's what he was made of?
Yeah.
He did that because that's what he was
he
made of.
He dug deep and came through?
Exactly. How many guys have you seen that? I mean, Chavez, Mojay Taylor. Mojay Taylor was boxing the brakes out of Chavez.
Yeah.
Chavez kept on.
Caught him.
finally clipped him.
Yeah.
That's character, man.
Having no quit in him.
Exactly, it's character, bro. That's why I'm here still standing. That's why, I mean, we gunning for the world title. We not doing it just to do this, like,
so
this is a real run.
It looks like to me, you're getting better and better and better. So I'm just observing you.
Yeah.
Triple G is signing with the Zone. He's a little older. He may not be the Triple G he was. Maybe he still is. I don't know. Uh-huh. A rematch with you and him will be very interesting.
Yeah.
Is that something you would like if it came up?
Absolutely. I mean,
he still punches. You know, fighters, they say the last thing they lose is power. He still hits hard.
I like a challenge. Like, for instance, the guy I'm fighting is a challenge. You know, they have presented a few names before Selecki. You know what I'm saying? And at one point, it came down to they gave me a welterweight.
Yeah.
They would come up and wait to fight me. I said, I'm not fighting no welterweight. I said, I'm not doing it.
You don't want someone jumping up two weight classes.
I'm not about to whip on a welterweight. And then they're gonna say, oh, he's too small, of course. You know what I'm saying? And then Selecki came into the picture, and I love that fight. Because the man is game, he can fight, he's tough, and is the type of challenge I need to test myself. It's the type of challenge I need to say so that a win against him, when I call out the big boys, people believe in it. You know what I'm saying? Because they go, yo, that was a good fight. You understand what I'm saying?
Absolutely. Let me ask you, have you ever sparred Canelo?
No.
Have you had any fighter ability that ever sparred Canelo? Who?
Dusty?
Oh, he's coming back.
Yeah, Dusty's good.
How did he do in Canelo's camp?
He said when he was working with Canelo, Canelo had first came back to camp, he was like a 185 solid. So he was running through most of his sparring partners, but he was able to, you know, keep him honest.
I think Dusty's 32-0, if I'm not mistaken.
No, he's 30-0-1.
How much
does he
Canelo Jacobs, very interesting fight.
Very interesting.
50-50, and I think it's a very close
fight. You know what I mean?
I think
Gary Stark and them guys up in New York, they're my people. I love them to death.
How about Gabe Rosaod against the winner?
That would be excellent.
Because I think, there's two or three belts on the line for that fight.
WBA.
WBC?
IBF.
And WBC.
WBA. That's kind of has the WBA.
Yeah.
WBC and IBF. And he has the ring.
The four?
Yeah. Oh, hold on. He may have the IBO as well.
So that's five.
Yeah. Elie, make sure you introduce the boxing world to my man Jason. The man, I'm telling you.
Jason, he looks like he could be your lawyer.
No, he got like three master degrees.
His wife's a lawyer.
Yo, he got like three master degrees. He does it by choice. He's like a mad scientist.
What's your master's degree in?
I'm getting my second master's in integrated marketing.
Okay.
That's a hybrid MBA program. So my other one's in secondary ed English.
Are you Canadian?
No.
No, no, I see Arturo Gotti. That's why I was asking.
Oh, no, he's born it up.
No, he's Pittsburgh, baby. Steel town.
Oh, he jacked it from you?
From the PA. He gets a different part.
I jacked this from here.
Yeah.
Part of my.
Hey, Gotti, people love them no matter what.
Ooh.
In this day and age, if you have a loss, people, he lost. I mean, it doesn't matter if you put on a war.
I think that's unfortunate, but I think that's all changing.
It isn't changing, because look, in MMA, you can have 7, 8, 10, 11 losses and still be the best in the world, one of the best, and the fans love you. But in boxing, for some reason, we live in this culture where two losses and you get cut from your promoter.
Yeah.
Why is that? I mean, not every video that I post is a home run.
Yeah.
Right?
I feel like they think they can market the aura of invincibility.
Hey, thank you so much. Thank you for letting me record today. No. Appreciate it. Thank you. I will.
How
do you get your name?
Jason.
What's your...
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. Thanks so much for tuning in. ES News, your source for your boxing news. I'm Elie Seckbach. Reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach, and you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.
Ain't doing much, take a step back, cause it's Elie Seckbach.